Our next guest is a veteran actress who's appeared on hit shows like Scrubs, Everybody Hates Chris, and Desperate Housewives.
And now she's generating buzz for her breakout role in NBC's The Mysteries of Laura, which was just renewed for a second season.
Yay!
That's right. Here to tell us all about it is Alysia Joy Powell. Welcome to the show.
Hello, y'all. How you doing?
It was renewed for a second season.
Yes.
You must be thrilled.
They did it again.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, because our fans are fierce.
Now, where were you when you heard the news? How'd you react?
Okay, so this is funny.
Uh-huh.
I was on Twitter, and the fans were going crazy.
Aww.
Like, they needed therapy. They needed some assistance. And they were hitting me up and everything. And I said, okay, you guys, just, you know, have some faith.
Yeah.
Just breathe. And y'all go to sleep, okay?
Okay.
Go to sleep. It was one fan, you know, because it was before Mother's Day.
Right.
And so she was supposed to go out with her husband.
Uh-huh.
And she was talking about, I'm not going anywhere until I find out. And I said, girl, put on your hoe pumps and go out with your husband. But okay, we'll
right.
tweet
your what pumps?
Your hoe pumps.
Hoe pumps.
The high ones. You know what I'm saying? To get it busy, get it cracking. We ain't breaking up no marriages on Mysteries of Laura, okay? We're trying to keep the family together.
I love that.
Yes.
I love that.
So right. I found out, actually, my phone started going off at midnight.
Okay.
They made us wait to the very last minute. And at midnight, everybody started going crazy. And I was like, okay, I think it's happening.
Well, I already knew it was going to happen because it is an amazing show. It's
sure
a lot of fun.
Is.
It's funny. It's like a comedic Law and Order.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
All right, so tell us a little bit more about the show for those that unfortunately may not be watching.
Well, you said it perfectly.
Okay.
It's a comedic Law and Order.
Yeah.
And and the Deborah Messing plays a detective who's a public success and a private failure.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I take care of the private failure. The two kids at home, I play Nanny Alysia.
And Laz Alonso is also on the show.
Yes, he's a friend darling.
Yes,
darling.
So is that a perk?
Baby.
Oh, whoa.
Nice.
Wait a minute.
It's a very nice thing. Yes.
Hoping he needs some rearing too, are you?
Oh, yes, I can tame the shrew.
It made you grab the girl.
Oh, yes, right. Yes,
hey,
yes.
All right.
Yes.
Well,
we need air conditioning.
You are a trip.
It's hot in her.
Let's take a look at a clip of you in action and then discuss.
Oh, yes.
Nanny Alysia, I like you.
I heard something about no talking.
That's right. It was silent reading time.
Well, that makes perfect sense. I didn't know about the reading.
Right, oh, well, you know what? While we're on that subject, if I were you, I'd work on that out loud reading time, too.
What does that mean?
I mean, your two little princes over there are a little bit behind the eight ball on their basic reading skills. When my kids were young, I worked 60 hours a week, and I read all the Harry Potter books to them. Out loud. They read a page, I read a page, Hogwarts, Hagrid's, the whole nine yards. And I hate Harry Potter.
He says,
awesome.
Who hates Harry Potter?
Hogwarts. Wait, so how'd you land this gig?
Oh, now that's Jesus.
Oh, amen.
Okay, so my agent submitted me for two words. Yeah, didn't like that. She should have checked the resume, but it's okay.
Okay.
I went in there and I said, listen, we are not doing these two words.
Uh-huh.
Me and Jesus went in there and did us.
You did it.
Yes.
Really?
And then
and
when
what
I got
that
to
entail?
The hey, when I got to the set, the director said, I loved your audition tape. I said, is that what we doing? He said, that's what we doing.
Nice.
So from the time I saw the boys on the bridge, this was for the pilot.
Okay.
From the time I saw the boys on the bridge, I ranted all the way to the end of the bridge.
Are you serious?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, that's nasty. Uh-huh. Two kids peeing on each other, that's what's wrong with America. Oh, yeah. Uh-huh, that's some nasty-ass stuff you're doing, yes. So that's why I need to get out my belt. If you whoop these white kids, then they wouldn't be out of line. And all the way to the end of the bridge, and everybody was like...
And that's how you won the part.
And then they called my agent and said, we don't know where to place her, but we want her.
Wow.
And every scene is pretty much like that. She's going off on her kids and the parents. She gives it to them like it's real, and that's why we love it.
Yeah.
But will your one-woman show be just as real? It's called Different Shades of Love.
Yes. Oh, my gosh,
more.
My baby. It's about different shades of love. It's monologues. It's a montage of monologues and poetry and music that is very nostalgic.
Oh.
It starts off chronologically for me as a child, and then it goes into different characters. So I start off as a little girl, and I go all the way to Mrs. Johnson, who's an older woman.
Wow, and you sing gospel as well?
Yeah.
And you have a jewelry line?
I have a jewelry line, and I'm going to have a clothing line soon.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, I write. I also direct.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, and I have this special project I want to produce as a feature film.
Okay.
Yeah.
Will you come back and tell us all about that
when
you get started?
I will.
And real quick, when and where can we catch Different Shades of Love?
You know what? We're working on that now. I'm in meetings now with this.
Okay.
It's kind of taking on a life of its own. But I will be showcasing it in North Carolina at the Black Theater Festival.
All right.
Well, until then, we can catch you on The Mysteries of Laura on NBC.
Yes.
Season 2 coming up.
Yeah.
All right. Congratulations. Yay. Thank you so much for joining us.
All right.
And you're watching Arise Entertainment 360.